In this video, I'm going to show you how I created a ring to make old peanut butter caps stackable. You might think, why peanut butter caps? Well, I use them for a lot of things, like batteries, nails, LEDs, and resistors. But there is a tiny disadvantage of these caps. When you want to stack them, they don't stick together, they kind of move. So that is why I created this ring, which makes them perfectly stackable. For this video, I assume you already know a little bit about Fusion 360. I will not cover all the steps in detail. I will create another series Fusion 360 for beginners in the future. For now, I just want to show you how I've created these rings so you can use it in your own projects. In order to make our stackable ring, I need to make two sides, a top and a bottom. These both have different heights, so what I did was I created four circles. This outer circle together with this inner circle makes the top edge of our ring. And this outer circle with this inner circle make up the bottom edge of our ring. In order to make our design flexible, I'm using parameters. So I'm going to modify, change parameters, and here I set up three different parameters for the top and also three for the bottom. If you want to change the diameter, you can change it over here and your 3D model will automatically adjust. So that's very useful. I have a top outer diameter, top inner diameter, and the height, and they're both specify the dimensions of the top layer. I did the same for the bottom with the bottom outer diameter, bottom inner diameter, and the bottom height. And as you can see, also use some kind of formula to calculate these inner diameters. I take the outer diameter and extract 5 millimeters from this value. And in this way, we can set all the measurements for our model. If I go back to my sketch in edit mode, you'll see here all the FX markings. And FX is these parameters. So this 92 is not really 92, but it's a top outer diameter. And I did the same for the top inner diameter. And I also did this at the bottom. At the bottom, I used the bottom inner diameter and the bottom outer diameter. In this way, we can have defined all these dimensions. And now we can have a look at the extruding of these circles because we want to make the top and bottom edge. So I stop my sketch and switch to a 3D view so you can see it a little bit easier. And when I step one step in the future, you see I've extruded my top edge. When I edit this feature, you can see that the height is defined by the top height. So in this way, this is also a dynamic value, a parameter. So if we continue another step, you also see the bottom being extruded. And here we did the same thing. If I edit this feature, you can see that here I use the bottom height. So there is one tiny issue. And if we zoom in a little bit further, you see here we make a very sharp edge. For a 3D printer, you need support material or used to print supports. And that's not what I want. So what I did was I created this rounding on it. And if I go one step further, you see the fillet operation. And the fillet operation makes it smoother. So now it's a little bit rounded. I also used a parameter for this, but not a parameter from the settings. I used a calculation. So if I edit this feature and you look over here, you see I take the top inner diameter minus the bottom inner diameter and I divide it by 2, and that's exactly the amount we need to make a perfect round edge on this part. So our design is finished and we can now send it to the 3D printer via Cura. I'm now going to show you how I did this. So in order to send this to the 3D printer, I'm going to Tools, say Make and 3D Print. Then I have to select my object and press OK. Now it will be translated into Cura, which you can download from the link below. So it's 90 degrees off, so I'm going to rotate it to make it perfectly flat. And now you can see that I'm going to enlarge it a little bit because I made some draft prints and it shows that it was 1 millimeter off. So I make it 101%. So it's a little bit enlarged. So the measurements I've made are accurate. I'm using a draft quality of 0.2 mils and that's enough for this ring. So my printer is very busy with printing this whole ring. I'm using black PLA and printing on a heat of 200 degrees and the heat bed is 60 degrees. So if everything runs smooth, we're done in 24 minutes and then we'll see how the ring looks like on the actual cap. So this is the finished ring. I've glued it with a small piece of glue. You don't need to glue the whole ring. And as a result, you have a perfect stackable cap, as you can see over here. Now you just need to repeat this process for all the caps you have. And that concludes this tutorial. In the description of this video, you find a link to the STL files and the Fusion 360 files, so you can edit it on your own. Keep in mind that I've used these parameters so you can adjust them for the measurements of your own caps. I see you in the next video.